written, I think, 200,000 words of a straight narrative. And it was thick and it was impenetrable, and you couldn't, it was unreadable. I was watching a documentary about Philippine weavers in the south, in Mindanao, and I saw that to create the textiles that they use for loincloths and other garments, these women would develop individual threads first and foremost, and then these threads would become thicker and thicker until they were finally woven into a cohesive fabric. And from that fabric they were able to, or from those threads they were able to create patterns. You know, this is a really interesting thing. This is the way to do it. It was sort of, you know, my eureka moment. I thought, wow, I have to take the book apart. So I took it apart. I opened up 10 different Microsoft Word documents, and I wove those individual threads on their own, rather than trying to write the entire fabric itself. I figured, okay, well, let's take a page out of their book and make something different. Try a different approach, and so that's what I did. And I developed all of these different narratives on their own, knowing full well that, you know, most of them would end up on the cutting room floor, but at least I was able to use them somehow, and what is cut would resonate somehow with the readers, I think, or at least in my head as a writer it would. So that's what I did. Towards the end, though, I was having a really hard time keeping track of everything. So what I would do is, I developed this system. I summarized each and every fragment in Ilustrado in a one-sentence summary. Then I color-coded each of those fragments according to which narrative thread they were part of. I printed that out on a thick sort of cardboard or a thick paper, cut them into strips individually, so I had this pile of different slips of paper that corresponded to all the different fragments. I backed those with Velcro, and then I opened up these file folders, which I also backed up backed with Velcro. And each file folder represented a single chapter. So I had 10 chapters, so I had 10 different file folders, and I spread them out on the desk in front of me, and I had this pile of fragments, and from that I was able to work on the narrative trajectory within each chapter and then within the overall book. So it got to a point where just writing straight onto the computer became a dead end. And I needed to have this very tactile, very literally bricolage, which the book is. This process really helped me figure out how to wrap my head around the many, many disparate fragments and threads within the novel. And yeah, that's pretty much the book in a nutshell. 4 years of hard work, but that's it.